on your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do, do 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 do, do do do, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
I know some great picture passes for our Bible adventure.
Friends, you and I will be picture pass guessers together.
Here's your first clue. It's a place you can go to learn.
Friends, which picture pass is it? Great job, friends! It's the school! Catch it in your adventure bag! Shine, what's next?
This one is something you use to feed yourself.
Friends, which one is it? Great job, friends! It's the spoon! Catch it in your adventure bag!
Now for the last one. You use it to turn the lights on and off.
Friends, which one is Shine talking about? You've got it, friends! It's the light switch. Let's catch it in our adventure bags. Friends, count with me. One. Two, three! Yep, they're all here. Now let's zip our adventure bag together. Now it's time to fly! Whoa! Whoa! Shine, I love reading my Bible, but what's it really about?
The Bible tells us what the Bible's all about.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
God's good news. That's the story of the whole Bible.
The whole Bible? Wow! Let's see what it's about.
Good day, Harvest Kids. My name is Miss Monique, and today I am going to tell you a beautiful story in the Bible. Last week, you learned about a man named Saul. And while he was going on Damascus Road, he had an encounter with Jesus. Jesus called him. And God changed his name from Saul to Paul. The Bible tells us that Paul became a missionary. That means he was going from city to city, sharing the good news about Jesus, telling people that they must put their trust in Jesus. While Paul went to the city of Derbe and Lystra, Paul met a young man by the name of Timothy. Timothy loved the Lord, and everybody was speaking good of Timothy. Boys and girls, Timothy began to travel with Paul, and they will go from city to city sharing the good news, telling people about Jesus. Then something bad happened. They put Paul into prison. Yes, they put him into prison. And some people will even say jail. And while Paul was in prison, Paul wrote a letter. In the book of 2 Timothy, Paul wrote a letter to Timothy. And Paul says, Timothy, I am thinking about you in the morning and in the evening, and I can't wait to reunite with you. I remember the tears that fall from your eyes when I was leaving. But Paul said to Timothy, Timothy, keep sharing the good news of Jesus. Don't be afraid, because God did not give you a spirit of fear, but of love and of a sound mind. Don't be afraid to tell people about Jesus. When Timothy was a little child, his grandmother, Lois, and mother, Eunice, they were telling Timothy about Jesus. They were sharing the word of God with him. And that stayed with Timothy. And Paul is saying, Timothy, you have the word of God inside of you. And you keep being strong. Timothy, don't be afraid to tell people about Jesus. And Paul goes on to say, Timothy, the word of God, this, the Bible I have in my hand, the word of God is good for teaching. The word of God is good for correcting. And the word of God help us to honor God. When you read the word of God, those of you who can read and those of you who can't read, your mommy or your daddy can read the word of God to you. But anytime you read the word of God, the word of God stays inside of you. And the Holy Spirit will help you to understand the word of God. And the Holy Spirit will help you to be brave to share the good news with your friends, maybe a family member who don't know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Boys and girls, let us keep sharing the good news about Jesus. Let us be brave. You see, Paul was put in prison for sharing the gospel. And sometimes we will go through persecution. We will face trials. But boys and girls, God will give you the strength to cope with every trials that you will go through. Keep praying. Keep reading the word of God and keep sharing the good news about Jesus, because this is what God wants us to do as his children. Thank you so much, boys and girls.
Friends, wiggle your ears if you want to learn a verse about it. Okay, here goes.
Open up your Bibles to the New Testament, Mark 16, verse 15. And he said unto them, go to all the world and preach the gospel to all the creations. Mark 16, verse 15.
Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for today. We thank you for your word. We thank you that your word is alive inside of our hearts. We thank you that you're giving us opportunities to share the good news of Jesus. Father, I pray that where we are fearful, where we are afraid, that you will give us the boldness like Paul to say to people, Jesus loves you and he wants to have a relationship with you. Father, I pray that you will help our boys and girls to be strong. Help our parents to be strong. I pray, Father, just like how Jesus was a great teacher, that we will listen from our pastors, we will listen from our church leaders, we will listen to our parents as they speak to us about Jesus, and that you will help us to keep doing the same thing by sharing Jesus with people out there who don't know him as Lord and Savior. So thank you, Lord, for today. In your name I pray. Amen.
Hey, don't forget to click like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And remember, you are loved.